Hello and welcome to the Windsor Stadium here in the northwest of Sydney for day six of the Emerging Nations World Championships. And to kick off day six, we have the Mediterranean Middle East up against ASEAN.
And the Confederate Cup. Number one, Ahmed Razai.
For most of these players, it'll be their third game in 5 days. So it's a big effort from these guys to even be out on the field, to be honest. We'll go through the Mediterranean Middle East side. At fullback, you've got Ahmed Rezzi. The wingers are Omer Khan and Hamza Anwar. In the centres, we've got Ahmed Kazem and Mohamed Sultan. The halves are Christian Tarabay and Hassan Rafai. The front rowers are Isaac Prokopayo and Luke Fredatovic. And the hooker is Kada Mitwari. The back rowers are Hussein Mirbani, Ali Elaz and Ahmed Elaz. On the bench, you've got Sayer Slimankel, Ahmed Al-Ali and Jay Jagadish, Zain Kazem. And that is the Mediterranean Middle East side. The ASEAN side at fullback is Ryan Clark. The wingers are Tote Gill and Tony Jiang. The centres are Isaac Gruen and Richard Mantay. The halves are Tyler Chant and James Mabey. The front rowers are Corey Kerner and Richard Planker. The hooker and captain is Nathan Arnhemnart. In the back row, we've got John Hanley and Jeff Peters. And the left forward is Trent Kerner. On the bench, we've got Thomas Saren Gaya, Odyssey Lateris, Josh Foley and Rhys Tucker. That is the ASEAN team for today.
Number 10, Richard
Planker. The Mediterranean Middle East side, they're looking for three wins on the trot. Last Sunday, they defeated the Latin Heat 26-12. And then on Tuesday, they got over African United 35-18.
Number 17, Josh Foley. And number 19, Rhys Tucker.
ASEAN, they went down in their first game, 28-20 against Africa United. That was at the Ponds in Kellyville. And then on Tuesday, they got a win up against the Latin Heat, 30-20. So another big day here on Bar TV Sports. Four games coming your way. After this one, we have the Latin Heat taking on Africa United, followed by Australia v New Zealand in the PDRL. And then to wrap up day six, we have Hong Kong v Japan. Mekan gets us underway, and it's a very good start from Mediterranean Middle East. That one just belted into touch. So a scramble pack on the 30. The Mediterranean getting the scrum feet. And a warm welcome to wherever you are around the world. Hope you're enjoying the stream, the coverage Bar TV's been providing for these Emerging Nations World Championships. Send us a message or a comment on Facebook. Let us know where you're tuning in from. As Mediterranean go on the attack, go through the hands straight away, and Ahmed Rezzi will take the first tackle of this contest. They go down the short side. Anwar. Well, here's the big 19. Mirbani takes it up to the 20. Prokopayo out the back to Rafai. Linking up here at the fullback. Rezzi's got some space here. Offloads it here. We got the first try to Ali Elaz. Just to the right of the uprights. Quick hands, quick ball movement from Mediterranean Middle East. And they open up with the first points. So only 2 minutes gone in this contest, and we can see on the replay, good shape here from Mediterranean Middle East, and a good step there from Rezzi, and put the big fella, Ali Elaz, over, basically untouched, as the in defence just got there too late.
That's right, Mediterranean Middle East got one under 20, Ali Elaz, has scored at Mediterranean Middle East 4, ASEAN 0, with the kick to come. Yeah, keep on the kick.
So Christian Tarabay lines this one up. Adds the extra, so it's 6-0. Mediterranean Middle East over ASEAN. These two teams. Best way you can describe these two teams are they're very similar to the West Indies cricket setup. A mixture of nations. ASEAN, 10 nations make up the ASEAN. A couple of players from Philippines, India, Cambodia, Thailand, Malaysia, Burma as well. There's probably a couple more there I've missed out. And it's the same with the Mediterranean Middle East side. Chant gets us back underway. Rafael will take it. He's juggled it. Referee says it's been knocked back. No, now he calls knock on. Sam Rafael probably thought he got away with that one. Referee just looked to his touchies. He gave him the call. So now ASEAN with an opportunity here to get some points. We see here on the replay just a little fumble. As we see so often in rugby league, the team that scores points just switch off for that split second. So what have ASEAN got here? Maybe. Running to the line. James Maybe, Malaysian. Here's the 13, Kernoff. Trent Kernoff. Brought down 6 metres out from the try line. They come this left-hand side, Chant. Inside pass to Peters. Peters bumps away from one. Eventually he's wrapped up there around the legs from Elaz. Quick play the ball. It's another opportunity here. The ball's come loose. And Ahmed Rezi dives on it for Mediterranean Middle East. So, first opportunity for ASEAN. Comes up short. Good defence on their goal line from Mediterranean Middle East. Here's Kazem. Ahmed Kazem. Mediterranean Middle East. No. Black jersey with the white V. ASEAN in the red, gold and blue. Oh, big hit there. Bouncing out of the tackle. They're still going here. Down the short side is Mohammed Sultan. Luka Fredatovic just ran straight into a brick wall. Bounced off, gives the offload, and now Mediterranean Middle East get a penalty. Leg pull, the ruling there from the referee. If you're new to the rules of rugby league, once a tackle's completed, the tackling player cannot pull the leg. It's a disadvantage to the attacking team, just slowing the play the ball down. It's against the rules. So Mediterranean Middle East go into ASEAN territory once more. Kota Mitwari gets us back underway, and here's the try scorer, Ali Elaz. Good first hit up. Fredatovic through the hands. They go to Ahmed Elaz. They're 15 out from ASEAN's line. Fredatovic playing first receiver. Tarabay does the dummy. He's gone straight through. He's got support. We've got another try. Ahmed Kazem is over for Mediterranean Middle East. Two tries in the opening 5 minutes. And it's Mediterranean Middle East 10. ASEAN 0. So the Mediterranean Middle East boys, only the one hiccup so far, but they come out firing. You can see on the replay, great shape. Good dummy there from Tarabay. One arm pass to Kazem. Ahmed Kazem goes over to score the try. Ahmed Kazem plays his local footy here in Sydney with the Bankstown Bulls. Majority of these players, the Mediterranean Middle East team, having European heritage. So Christian Tarabay from the sideline pretty much. He strikes it nicely. He's going to have the legs. No, it's waved away. So it remains 10 points to nil. The Mediterranean Middle East over ASEAN here in the Confederate Cup. This is their third game in 5 days. Heard some interesting stories during this Emerging Nations Championships, especially with the Greece team. Struggled to fill their squad for yesterday's game. Had to fly a couple of boys down from Brisbane as we have another mistake from the kickoff. ASEAN get the ball back here for perfect opportunity to post points, and Mediterranean Middle East, as they did previously after scoring a try, have just gone to sleep again. So, scramble pack on the 10 metres line. Tyler Champ gets us back underway. James McBee going out to the fullback, Ryan Clark. Ryan Clark's wrapped up on that 10 metre zone. Richard Mante at dummy half. Goes for a little run. Gets ASEAN centre field. Got numbers both sides. They're setting up to the left. Armand, oh, it comes that way now. Han Lee. He's a metre out from the line. So go to the right-hand side now. Maybe inside pass here. Good defence from the Mediterranean Middle East boys. Can ASEAN get a try here? As Sarageo pops a pass to the big number 8, Corey Kerner. And ASEAN hits straight back. It's 10-4 with a kick to come. Good stuff from the ASEAN team. Invited into the Mediterranean Middle East territory, so they had to come up with points. Corey Kerner, two Kerners in the side. We see boys just having a drink. Been a pretty busy opening 10 minutes to this clash. As Tyler Chant will line this one up to add the extras. Does so. So it's now 10 points to 6.
Score by number 8, Corey Kerner. Has the score to, with the conversion successful, has the score to
into the replay.
10.
Went through a gaping hole. Mediterranean Middle East boys just not numbering up there, but good play from ASEAN. Opening 10 minutes, 3 tries, entertaining so far. Sam Rafay gets us back underway. Tyler Champ with a very good take. Richard Planker is wrapped up. 15 out from his own line. So, Mediterranean Middle East, they're 2 from 2 in this Confederate Cup so far. ASEAN, well, they got a 50% record. The winner of this one could see them land top of the groupings. Han Lee out on that right edge is wrapped up, 35 out from the ASEAN line. Maybe he'll put this one down. It's not a bad kick, but good take there from Armand Rezzi. Read that one well. Does the dummy to his outside man, Hamid Khan. Just take the tackle. Kazam running across field. Armand Kazam. Sultan at dummy half. Rafayi fires the 13. Ahmed Elaz. Tarabay runs to the line. Good tackle there. Prokopaya probably thought he was through a half gap. A bit worried. A bit of a scamper from dummy half. Linking up with Tarabay. And Mohamed Kazem will take the tackle. Last tackle for Mediterranean Middle East. Tarabay with a high kick. It's a spiralling bomb. Richard Clark does well to take it. He's got a bit of space if he can get around. No, it's a very good grab there from Mohamed Sultan. Around the collar. So, ASEAN players just a little bit bunched here. I said that you can forgive the teams. They're playing their third game in 5 days. Richard Mantyke. Another run there. And we've got a penalty here to the ASEAN side. So this will ease the pressure. Just a fraction. ASEAN will go on the attack 30 metres out from the Mediterranean Middle East line. There's the first hit up from the try scorer, Corey Kerneth. The other short side. There's a good run here from Han Lee. 10 out from the line. Can ASEAN get their second here? It's a good run here from Peters. Within 5 of the try line. They're set deep. Out to this left-hand side. Kerneth linking up with Chant. Nice pass out there. He did well to take that grill and flicks it out the back. It's picked up by Chant. There's a chance here on the corner for Jing. He's got it down. Isaac Gruen's the try scorer. The referee likes it. Points to the spot. And ASEAN level things here at 10-all. 15 gone in the first half. So well done there from Isaac Gruen. The wind picks up. So this will be a typical kick here for Tyler Chant coming up. As we see on the replay, Tyler Chant did well there. He threw that pass and he comes back around to link up. Ball could have been deflected there, and then Chant throws it again. Isaac Gruen, he had a fair bit of work to do. There's plenty of players around. He got through for the try. So 10-all. Tuning into the stream, let us know where you're watching from. Mo Mengen is watching from the Gold Coast. Tyler Chant, he's just put that across the face of the uprights. So it remains 10-all here in the Confederate Cup. Mediterranean Middle East, they've started off well. ASEAN's hit back. Question there, who's playing? Well, it's Mediterranean Middle East against ASEAN. Mediterranean Middle East have made up by a number of countries. A lot of these players have got heritage around the Mediterranean. And ASEAN's made up of at least 10 nations. From India, Philippines, Cambodia, Thailand, Malaysia, China, Burma. It's good to have them all involved with rugby league. The volunteers are doing a great job. Here's Kerneth. So it's a good fight back from ASEAN. And a train in Middle East. They'll have to muscle up, and they do with that tackle. Ahmed Kazem, the main offender in that tackle. Stuff as they get in the short side here. Saw a half gap, but it closed quickly. Go through the hands, a couple there, and bumping out of a tackle is Planker. Richard Planker will play this 5 short of halfway. Go back to that short side again, and maybe puts it on the toe. Ahmed Rezi runs back to pick it up. He's got a wall of ASEAN defenders there. making the tackle was James Mabey. Some Mediterranean Middle East bringing this out with Hamza Anwar. Here's Fredatovic. Kadamitwari at dummy half. Look out for him to scoot out from dummy half. So far, he's just been offloading the ball. Rafayi taking the tackle. Is Tarabay. Good defence there again from Mazian. Kurnoff and Planka involved. There's a kick from Mitwari. It's a difficult one there for Gruen. Gruen, try scorer here. Just runs straight into Sultan. Trying to wrestle away from Khan as well, and eventually he's brought down. 12 out from his own line. That's Jiang playing the ball. His first touch, I believe. Flick out the back here. So Asien pinching a couple more metres here of Richard Clark. Clark linking up with Kermit in support. Going out to the right hand side again, so making some easy meters out on that edge. And as the rain comes down here again, as it has done all tournament, Ahmed Rezi. Oh, he's fumbled it. So another mistake here for Mediterranean Middle East. As in, with a great opportunity halfway through this first half, it's 10 all. That rain looks quite heavy out on the field. Not sure if you can pick that up on your monitors, but it's been a tournament of wet weather. So he had it just slipped out of his grasp, the ball getting a bit greasy out there for the players. So the wind really picks up. Just lost one of my programs off the grandstand. Lucky I grabbed a pile. Lose one. Just grab another. So pushing the scrum here from Mediterranean Middle East. Thank you, sir, as the program comes back. It's one good thing about all these emerging nations teams, the volunteers. They're so very helpful. A lot of them have given up their time to join in the commentary to help out. So Asien, Chen, inside pass there to Jiang. Tommy Jiang will play the ball. Arnott, he's Peters, 2 metres out from the line. Got plenty of numbers out the right hand side. They go that way, maybe running to the line. Still 2 metres out here, Asien. Big bunch of bodies in the middle of the field. Is Kurnoff looking for a second? Brought down inches from the line. Go to Chan again. Tyler Chan, a long pass out here. We've got another try in the corner. Asien's over. Isaac Gruen gets his second try of the afternoon. Asien hit the front, 14-10. Great vision from Tyler Chant. Isaac Gruen couldn't believe his luck. Well done, the Asian boys. You see on the replay, great vision here from Tyler Chant. That's a lovely pass, almost 30 metres. Isaac Gruen runs around a little bit to improve the position. Very close to that dead ball line.
That's right, Asien. Score by number 5. Isaac Gruen takes a score to Asien 14. Mediterranean 10 with a kick to come.
Hear that wind picking up through the effects, Mike. Apologies about that. That rain's almost coming in sideways now. Spectators will be up with us shortly in the the open box. Tyler Chan, it's not a bad strike. It's over. So, it's ASEAN 16, Mediterranean Middle East 10. It's a good fight back. It's a good ASEAN even 16, game.
Mediterranean Middle East 10.
ASEAN's had the weight of possession these last 10 minutes or so. Said a strong breeze, Mediterranean Middle East are running into here at Windsor. So Rafai gets us underway, goes straight up the field on the wind, drags it across to the left-hand side. Josh Foley overran Tyler Chant, so Chant just takes the tackle. A run from dummy half. St. Peters, number 12. So if you just tuned into the coverage, you're watching Bar TV's Emerging Nations World Championships. This is the Confederate Cup. Paul Arundel in commentary with you. It's Josh Foley's driven back into the turf. Will the sand in the case of that part of the field. Here's the lock forward, Trent Kerner. Ball's come loose. It's picked up by Mabey. Oh. And interesting tackle there from Kota Mitwari. Both got tangled up. He's just flipped maybe around. It's just one of those tackles where it was just a bit unfortunate. If there's any malice in the tackle of Mitwari, it's sometimes the way the bodies fall in rugby league. The referee will just have a couple of words to Kota Mitwari. He's on report. Here it is on the replay. And he's up on his feet. That's the main thing. So ASEAN will find touch. 35 out from the line. Yeah, back on the attack. There's Foley. Another hit up. Runs straight into Rafai. Muhammad Sultan. Rain has stopped. You can see a little bit of blue sky. Trent Kerneth. Take the tackle. Almost centre field. 20 out. Here's his brother, Corey Kerneth. Numbers both sides. They go to the right-hand side. Maybe running to the line. It's a long pass out there. To Richard Mantate. Mantate then pops it back to Maybe. Maybe dancing around. It's Kerneth. Looking for the run. Here he comes. Corey Kerner runs straight into Fredovic. Playing a bit of hot potato football here. This is Trent Kerner now wrestling with the defence. And now the boys get a little bit restless here. Bit of face slapping. Bit of shirt grabbing. It's getting a bit heated out there. Lots of pushing and shoving, but a few interesting words being exchanged as well. Here we go on the replay. Predatovic almost manhandles Kerner. Corey Kerner didn't like it. Brother stepping in, and they all come from everywhere. Pretty much just to break it up. So the referee's just separated the two teams. He's going to call out, looks like Sam Rafai, a halfback for Kazan, for Mediterranean Middle East. And also it's looks like it's the big number 20, Ali Laz. He scored the first try today. So if you're watching the stream and you're local, you're not far from the Windsor Stadium, come down. The Windsor Wolves Rugby League Club. They've got the canteen open. They've got the hot pies, the sausage rolls, bacon and egg rolls. You have drinks and lollies for the kids. Come down. The rain stopped. There's plenty of room in the grandstand. Plenty of room on the hill as well. Come down, watch some good rugby league of the emerging nations. As you get the penalty, and they'll go for goal here to extend the lead to 8 points. Play there for Mediterranean. Just getting taped up there. It's Ahmed Alaz. And he bandaged around his face in front of the goal sticks. So Tyler Chant adds the extras. So it's now ASEAN 18, Mediterranean Middle East 10. Heading into this final 15 minutes of this first half of the Confederate Cup.
Conversion to Central takes the score to ASEAN 18, Mediterranean Middle East 10.
If you just joined us, let us know where you're watching this match from. We'll try and keep this as interactive as we can. Back underway. Tarabay this time with the kicking duties. It goes straight to Chan again. Here goes Foley off the fence. And straight into the shoulder of Muhammad Sultan. Legal tackle. He had the arms wrapped around him. Peters. Sultan again in there to make the tackle. Predatovic and Alaz helping out. Kerner, involved in that little scuffle moments ago. Going out to the right hand side, maybe inside pass here. So goes back to Chant, put this on the boot. It's a good kick, good take there on that far side there by Hamza Anwar. Now tries to get around his opposite number. He does get around one, but he won't get around the tackle of Richard Mantate. So Mediterranean Middle East got off to a dream start. An early try. Now they find themselves behind the scoreboard. That's 18 points to 10, and there's another mistake by Fredatovic. There's Thomas Sarangaya. He's on the field in jersey 14 for ASEAN. He'll play the ball. They go out to the right-hand side. Hanley out on that right edge. They go through the hands. As Kerniff pops it out the back. It's a good bounce, or it's an awkward bounce there for Foley. He allowed it to bounce one more time and almost went away from the big fella. So Thomas Sarangaya, he's gone into dummy half. Nathan Arnott has come off the field. So they go again. Clark out the back to Mabey. Mabey jigging around, dancing. He's wrapped up there in a good tackle from Tarabay. 8 metres out from the Mediterranean Middle East line. Hanley straightens up, runs hard. Gets ASEAN within 3 metres. Stacked out onto this left-hand side. The kick's gone in the goal and Rafael was there, but the ball's been stolen. And ASEAN have a try. I think it's Trent Kerner has just pinched the pocket of Hassan Rafael. And ASEAN extend their lead. 22-10 with the kick to come. Great thinking from the lock forward. ASEAN, bit of a slow start. Now they're firing. You can see it here on the replay. Kick through. Good one-on-one tackle and just rips it out of the hands of Rafael. Highlight there for Trent Kerner. Not so much if you have some Rafael. Tyler Chant. We'll look to add the extras in this final 10 minutes of this first half of the Confederate Cup. Thank you. the great initiatives, this Confederate Cup, merging the nations together of continents to have this mini tournament inside the tournament of the emerging nations. Chant as the extras. So it's now 24-10. ASEAN over Mediterranean, Middle East. Up next, we've got the Latin Heat against Africa United. Followed by the PDRL second test match between Australia and New Zealand. Had the privilege of calling that 2 days ago. And then the last game here on day six is Hong Kong v Japan. That should be a beauty. Both teams love throwing the ball around. So Christian Tarabay gets us back underway. It's a deep kick. Chant, the goal kicker, takes it. And Foley, as he's done so often in this tournament, charges straight back into line. Almost getting to the 30. So a good start. So Isaac Gruen. Jeff Peters. Oh, solid contact. Frenatovic just lined him up. Corey Kerniff. Bumped away from one, but he's eventually brought down in that sandy part of the ground. So maybe running to the line there. Saw a half gap, but it closed quickly. Ahmed Kazem shut the door. So Tyler Chant goes to the sky. Ahmed Rezi waits for it and does well to take it. But the defence is there to wrap him up. It's Khan. Ahmed Khan coming in off his wing to help out the forwards. Predatovic, he had a little bit of a look there, juggled it, now the ball's come loose. And the referee has spotted the knock on. Predatovic may have just bobbled that into the defensive player. Touches the defensive player, it is a knock on. You see, most times now the ball is dropped, whether it's gone back or not, the referee will call a knock on. So a bit unfortunate here for Mediterranean Middle East. So we're back underway. Chant looking to go inside, but he finds Clark. Clark gets around his opposite number. Here's an opportunity here down the sideline. The defence comes across. He's still going here. Isaac Gruen, he's looking for a third. Now he's lost the ball. He's looking for the quick play, the ball, and he's just spilled it in an effort to get up. A good attacking play from ASEAN. They come up short. Now the referee's just called time off. Amir Carr, the number two, is just getting a bit of attention on the sideline from the trainer after making that tackle. So this is day six of the Emerging Nations World Championships. It's the third day we've been here in Windsor. We've had rain every day of the tournament, and the ground is holding up very well considering the amount of rain we've had here in Sydney. Amir Khan is coming from the field. Hopefully it's just for precaution. A lot of rain has fallen in Sydney. Hopefully they get plenty out west as well and up north. So he's the 24 on, Zain Kassam, charging into the line of defence, but the ASEAN players wrap him up. Fredatovic, lined him up, gets the offload, and Sleiman Kelp is on the field as well. Christian Tarabay, he inside pass here. It's Ali Kazem. He's the 13, Ahmed Alaz. Copped an early knock and he's got the tape around the ears. So Mitwari goes for a run from dummy half. The door quickly shut. So last tackle now for Mediterranean Middle East. Going out to the left-hand side, Christian Tarabay throws a long pass. Could have been forward to Kazem. Stepping back in field. Still the last tackle. Mitwari, bit of pressure on him. Mitwari's found a little bit of space. He chips and chases for himself. And now James Mabey picks it up. As Ian will bring us out of their own territory. Into the final 5 minutes of this first half. Gruen goes for a little run from dummy half. He's still wrestling. Rafael's wrapped him up. He's trying to pinch the ball. Referee says it's held. It's a Foley. I think he was going to be a decoy runner then. In the end, the ball's just bumped into Josh Foley. And we'll have a scrum feed to the Mediterranean Middle East. Well, to take Hill. He come off his far wing to have a run then. Indian Heritage to take Hill. Thomas Sarangaya, the other Indian player, I believe, in this ASEAN team. Remarkable effort to get this squad together. As Jay Jagadish is also on the field, so all the subs are out there on the field for the Mediterranean Middle East, but here's Fredatovic. He hasn't had a rest yet this first half. If he has, it's only been for a couple of minutes. Jagadish again, and now he's spilt the ball. So here's Arnamut. Mediterranean Middle East, it's the story of this first half. They get into a good position, they just spill the ball. They've had to do a lot of defending. And now they make things worse, giving away a penalty. Zian Rafaie, it's a little bit of niggle on the tackle. And the referee's picked it up, just trying to flip the play with the ball over after the tackle was completed. So that is a penalty to the ASEAN side. So, big chance here for ASEAN to extend their lead. Sonny Jiang taking a hit up. Cambodian player will play the ball. Here's Tyler Chan. Inside pass, here it is to Tutai Gill. Gill plays it 15 out from the line. Kurnath. Inside pass hit or running. Ryan Clark. He bumps off the tackle from Fredatovic. He gets to the 10-metre line. They spread deep. But Arnamut will go from dummy half. Back is Thomas Sarangaya. Got confused with the bright yellow boots there. Sarangaya just spilling the ball over the line. So a let off there for the Mediterranean Middle East. Sultan. So now the short side, inside pass here. Number 12, Sleiman Kell. Rafael. Inside pass here to Alaz. He gets away from one. Bumps off another. Ahmed Alaz, he's still going. Eventually he stopped. So, Rezi from dummy half. Tarabay. Kazem. Flicks it back to Tarabay. Quick hands here. This is Enwar. Enwar's brought down. And now he's into touch, but the referee says the ASEAN players thrown him over as Enwar goes for a run from dummy half. He's got support here. There's a big chance here. Fredatovic. Sultan's going to score. Mohammed Sultan's over in the corner. Good thinking from Hamza Enwar to take the quick tap. caught everybody off guard, including the commentator. And good vision too from the winger to link up in support. Fredatovic involved, and he just ran to the line, linking up with Mohamed Soltan. And a good try just before half time gets Mediterranean Middle East back into it. So the penalty was ruled, throwing the player into touch. And Enwar taking a quick tap, done well here. Good pass from the big front rower, Mohamed Soltan. Put the afterburners on. Scores out wide, so 24-14. Right on half time, as the Latin Heat players make their way to the sheds. They're up next against Africa United. So Christian Tarabay, 2 metres in from touch. Strikes it nicely, but it's not going to have the distance. Plus, it was wide, so it remains 24-14 here in the Confederate Cup match between Mediterranean Middle East and ASEAN. We'll take a quick break here on Bar TV and be back with the second half.
We'll score at half time in the match here. Moment, ASEAN 24, Mediterranean Middle East 14. Thank you. 10 back for the second half. Half time score again. ASEAN 24. Mediterranean Middle East 14.
Back here to the second half, and that's ASEAN leading Mediterranean Middle East 24 points to 14 here at the Windsor Stadium here in Northwest Sydney. Hope you're enjoying the coverage of Bar TV Sports. Hope you tune in all day. We've got four games. Tyler Chant will get us underway for this second half. King straight into that strong breeze. Good catch there from Raphael. Almost getting up to the 30 in that first tackle. Slow to get up and play the ball. Zane Kazan. Didn't see much game time in the first half. The number 11, Jagadish. So another run here from Kazan. Zane Kazan. It's a handful to put down onto the ground. Eventually he'll be made to play just short of halfway. So Raphael. Players got in each other's road there and he was going to kick it. So eventually he's just taking the tackle. So it's the last one now for Mediterranean Middle East. They come this short side. Christian Tarabay will just kick this down. Oh, nearly made a meal of it, Gill. Oh, big hit there from Tarabay on Gill. They both bounce back and hit each other again for a second time. So the number four, Richard Mante. He's done it a few times in the first half, helping the forwards out. Now they get a penalty, ASEAN. Mediterranean Middle East inside the 10 metres. A quick tap there, taken there by Sarangaya. The referee says, no, come back and play it on the mark. If you're unfamiliar with the rules of rugby league, the referee has to give the player with the ball the okay to take the quick tap. And obviously there, Thomas Sarangaya wasn't on the mark that the referee had pointed to. So now they can kick for touch. They'll start a full set of six here, right on halfway. Again, player not tapping the ball on the mark, so we'll go again. It's Kerner. He's got a good try in the first half. He's got his arms free, but he's wrapped up there by Kazan. Here's Foley. Inside pass to Corey Kerner. He flicks it back there to Sarangaya. Sarangaya is centre field, 25 out from the Mediterranean Middle East line. They go to the left-hand side. Here's Foley. Foley sees a half gap. He could be through here. Good tackle there from Ahmed Rezi. So, ASEAN looking for the first try in this second half. Skying will play it. Eight outs. Here's Chant. This is James Mabey. Well, it's a bit of a basketball pass to Latteras. Good innovation there from the halfback. Well, not so on that occasion. Good tackle that from Ahmed Kazan. As you play, just couldn't get boot to ball. Here it is on the replay. Latteras took the tackle, and on the next play, poor old halfback, Chase Mabey. Here it is, just tackle, good tackle, just couldn't get his boot to the ball. Knew what he wanted to do, but the defence had other ideas. So another full start here, we've had a couple of full starts here in this second half. Brenda Tovey. Stacked on the short side, Mediterranean Middle East. It's 4-on-1 down the short side at the moment. Mitwari comes that way, and it's an inside pass here to Jagadish. Still going. Rafaiz with it now. Linking up with Alaz. Alaz is met there by Peters and Kerneth. They're coming up to this left-hand side, but Rafaiz just decides to boot it downfield to the fullback Clark. Gets a nice bounce there, Ryan Clark. It's around a couple. He's still going. Ryan Clark eventually wrapped up by the kicker, Kazim Rafaiz. Oh, hand there in the pass, but it's been knocked on. From dummy half. Good thinking there from the halfback for Mediterranean Middle East. Square at marker. Stuck the hand out. See here on the replay. Dummy half. He just had a little bit of time to look and enough time there for Rafaeli to stick the hand out and block the pass. So good thinking there from the halfback. Mediterranean Middle East go on the attack. So just try to sort out their formation in the scrum. So they come out to this left hand side. Tarabay throws an intercept pass straight on the hands of Richard Mante. I'm not sure if he's going to have the pace here. Mitwari's coming across. Mante tries to beat him. Great tackle there from Kota Mitwari. Asian now 10 out for the Mediterranean Middle East line. And now they get a penalty. Holding down for too long in the play the ball. And Kota Mitwari will get 10 minutes in the bin. Unfortunate there for the Mediterranean Middle East team. Did all the good work, Mitwari, to make the cover tackle. So Mediterranean Middle East will play the next 10 minutes down to 12 men. Just hold on there for too long. It's Kerniff now. Five out from the try line. Foley, the decoy runner for Corey Kerniff. He dives underneath the post. He gets his second try of the day. And Asian go to a 28-14 lead. Super start. I said these two teams, or there's four teams in the Confederate Cup. It's their third game in 5 days, and there's going to be a lot of tired bodies out there. Corey Kerner, that close to the line. You're not going to stop him. Happy about that, Asian. So they defeated the Latin Heat 30-20. On Tuesday. They went down in their first game against Africa United 28-20. Tyler Chant adds the extras. 26, I beg your pardon. So Mediterranean Middle East.
It's
30-14. Just too busy trying to add up the for and against in my head, so apologies to the listeners, the viewers at home. Just proving I can't do two things at once. Still plenty of time for Mediterranean Middle East to come back in this one. They are down to 12 men. So I'll try and slow things down as much as they can here. It's a good kickoff. It'll be Corey Kerner, the try scorer, with the hit up. It's the number four, Richard Mante. Now penalty to Asian. So nothing going right for the Mediterranean Middle East boys here. So just above the grandstand, here's a dirty, big cloud hanging around the ground here, so we could be in for some rain shortly. Something different here at the Emerging Nations in Sydney. So Kerner with the kicking duties there. Finds touch. Almost takes out the official's tent. Back underway. Trent Kerner. Right on halfway. That's a sandpit part of the field. Here's Lateris. Well done to the groundsmen here at all the grounds, not only here at Windsor, but they've done a great job. As I said, we've had bucket loads of rain fall here on Windsor as we have a mistake. Pretty much from the opening day of this tournament, it has not stopped raining in Sydney. The grounds have held up remarkably well. We did have a day at the ponds at Kellyville on the synthetic ground. That held up a treat. So the scrum to pack 30 out from the Mediterranean Middle East line. It's a nice flat pass there, and Fayyid's wrapped up. So it'll be interesting to see what the Mediterranean Middle East do here without their regular dummy half. There's a very good run here from Slamakel. Still going, but now the ball pops out. Let's play on. Isaac Gruen, the man with the ball. Now he spilled it. Comedy of errors here at Windsor Stadium. Mia Khan now with it. So Mediterranean Middle East will go back on the attack. Rafael to Kazem. Bounces off one. So on the 20-metre line, Mediterranean Middle East play it. Almost got in the way of each other there. There's Tarabay. Linking up with the 11 here, and they've got numbers out here. There's a chance here. We've got a try for Mediterranean Middle East. Ahmed Kassam, he picks up a double. And down to 12 men, they hit back. So a good effort there for the Mediterranean Middle East. That's 30-18 with the kick to come. I've got a feeling this will be one of the longest attempts at conversion in history. I'll just try and eat up more time. Okay, the Mitwari spends a few more minutes in the sin bin. Here it is on the replay. Good numbers here. Well done by the back rower. Jay Jadadish to put Kazem over. Good little dive there at the end.
That's right, Mediterranean Middle East. Score by number 3. Ahmed Kazem takes the score to ASEAN 30. Mediterranean Middle East 18 with a kick to come.
So if you're watching this Bar TV coverage of the Emerging Nations on your phone, on the tablet, or hooked up to your TV, if you're on a bus, on a train, or just at home, maybe you're at work, let us know where you're watching from. As Tarabay's just sliced that one, and the score remains 30-18.
Conversion up successful, score remains ASEAN 30.
But at the margin, only 12.
18.
We're still, well, just over, under half an hour to go in this one. There's still plenty of time for the Mediterranean Middle East to hit back. And as I said, these boys are backing up their third game in 5 days, so there will be some tired bodies towards the end of this. And one of their star players is in the sin bin at the moment, which actually could do Mediterranean Middle East a favour if they don't let it another try. It'll come on a bit fresh. Good take there from Ahmed Kazem. A short kickoff from ASEAN. Enwar. There's a big body here just on the field. So Oscar Nasser. Nasser plays it. Rafael, short pass inside to Jagadish. The pass has gone forward. So Mediterranean Middle East there. I'm going to die wondering here. Still going on the attack. Again, they're just eating up a few more valuable seconds here. Big shout out to Peter Carrington watching in WA. It's Han Lee. He's had a good game. I'll give him a wrap, and he's just spilt the ball, so the commentator's cursed. Well, the referee says play on. Lucky to get away with that one. Referee was blindsided. Richard Planker. And a good first half for ASEAN. It's Kernoff now. Sees a forward pass from Sarangaya. Just getting a little bit scrappy here this last couple of minutes. Big hi to Wesley Koya, watching from the USA in Kansas City. Great to have you on board watching the coverage. I hope you're enjoying this one, the Confederate Cup. There's Hines, Kiwi. Well, they're up a little bit later on in the PDRL. Australia v New Zealand. And Gareth Shire watching again from Wales. He's got Wales UK. I thought you're from Wales. You are Welsh. Well, fumble there from Hamza Enwa. He's had a good game. Just that was a dodgy pass, so you can forgive him for fumbling that one. Great to have our Welsh viewers on board as well. Couple of teams playing in the League One in the English competition. See here on the replay, there's a dodgy pass. He caught that Anwar. He's Superman. So ASEAN centre field. Inside pass here to Han Lee. The door shut quickly. Ahmed Alaz with the tackle. Kernoff. To Kernoff. Corey Kernoff, he's got two tries today. Trent Kernoff has got one. So number 10, Richard Planker in a dummy half. Pitches a couple more metres. As the skipper comes back on for ASEAN, Nathan Narnamit. Richard Clark inside pass here to Reece Tucker. He's just come onto the field. So ASEAN, big opportunity here as Kernoff. Went straight into the defence. Nasser wrapped him up, ball and all, with the help of Tarabay. Last tackle for ASEAN. They come out to the right-hand side, and there's a hand there in the ruck, says the referee. Osama Nasser not square. That's the difference. We saw one earlier. Rafael was square at marker. Was allowed to reach out and grab the dummy half. And impeding passing the ball, but that one there, Osama Nasser, wasn't square. We'll see it here on the replay. Gareth Shire writes back, up the Crusaders. Yeah, the old North Wales Crusaders. We're the Celtic Crusaders, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong there, Gareth. So just over 20 minutes remaining in this one. ASEAN looking for a 14-point lead. He has the extras. So it's now 32-18. ASEAN over the Mediterranean Middle East.
The successful score now. ASEAN 32. Mediterranean Middle East 18.
So Mediterranean Middle East back to 13. Mitwari's back on the field. It's a deep kickoff. Good take there from maybe Tucker. Wrapped up there by Ali Alaz. Nathan Arnhem looked up at the referee. And he gave his teammate away there. It's a roll ball between the legs. The referees have been clamping down on that during this tournament. You must touch the ball with your foot, or at least make a genuine attempt to touch the ball with your foot. He's stuck up. He's thrilled not to have done so. So here's Alaz. Ali Alaz. Gets within 8 metres of the line. Mediterranean Middle East. Can they hit back? Fredatovic. Offload here. To Nasser. Fredatovic could have got a tackle there for ASEAN. So they're deep to the right-hand side. Rafayi, cut out pass here. Here's a strong run here. Jagadish, he deserves a try. He's been strong. He's just going to be brought down short. Still on the attack, Mediterranean. Short pass here. Prokopayu, he's appealing. But the referee says no, he spilt the ball. Good defence from ASEAN. So plenty of high-fiving and back-slapping there from the ASEAN boys. We'll have a scrum on the 10. Here it is. That was a good run there from Jagadish. They just went for the big play close to the line, but there was too many numbers there for ASEAN, and the ball just pops out. So big hi to Ricky Allen watching from Dunedin in New Zealand. Keep those messages coming in on Facebook. Richard Plank has driven back there. That man Fredatovic involved in the tackle. So come to the right hand side. Trent Kerner. Upended. Referee says it's okay. Tarabay and Armin Alaz in the tackle. Here's Corey Kerniff. James Mabey with the kick. It's a difficult one here. Luckily, Hamza Anwar's back there to help out his fullback. He'll take the tackle on the 30. Ahmed Razik. Alaz. This is Ahmed Alaz. And Mediterranean Middle East get a penalty here. Offside the ruling from the referee. ASEAN inside the 10 metres. Didn't think that was going to make touch, but he has done so. So Mediterranean Middle East, they've been down this part of the field for the last couple of minutes. They need to come up with points here. Sultan with a good first up run. Here's Luka Fredatovic. Wrestling there with Arnamut. Also Tucker. Alaz out the back to Tarabay. The defence is there to wrap him up though. Larry. Ahmed Alaz again. Still going with the legs. He's brought down two out from the try line. Slow play the ball. Here's he to Rafayi. It's a long pass out there. It's 11 Jagadish again. We've got a try in the corner. Amir Khan's over. The referee points to the spot. So Amir Khan gets another one for Mediterranean Middle East. 32-22 with the kick to come. So Mediterranean Middle East, they're not giving up in this one. In this last 20 minutes, crucial period for both teams. The forwards will be getting tired. So we might see the little men come into their own here. Try from Amir Khan. Finished off nicely, what all good wingers do.
Trotted Mediterranean Middle East scored by number 2. Amir Khan has scored a ASEAN 32. Mediterranean Middle East 22 with a kick to come.
So Hassan Rafai with the kicking duties now. Plenty of rugby league here today on Bar TV. Plenty of sport on Bar TV today. So the start of the Noosa Sevens coming up tomorrow. It's not a bad strike, but it's waved away. So it remains 32 points to 22. ASEAN over the Mediterranean Middle East.
32, Mediterranean Middle East, 22.
Heading into the final 15 minutes of this one. As the rain comes back, just when you think the rain's clearing, decides to swing back around and dump another bucket load on Windsor Stadium. Ball goes down to Ali Alaz and just runs straight into the defence. Corey Kerner is the first man there. Mediterranean Middle East bringing out with Hamza Anwar. Both wingers have been good for the Mediterranean Middle East. They've done plenty of that stuff to help out the forwards. Ahmed Alaz. Also been strong, flicks out the back, picked up by Sultan. It's a misty rain over the ground at the moment. It would make it difficult for the players as Iquari's made a mistake from dummy half. Greasy conditions. So, ASEAN referee not liking something there in the scrum. So we'll pack again. Big hello to Larissa Ann Perez, also watching. So Mante straight into Tarabay and the Laz is wrapped up. They come this short side, there's not many numbers here. Trent Kerner will take the tackle. Corey Kerner now. Penalty. Play the ball again, so that's the second one against ASEAN for it, the incorrect play the ball. Some of these players, they might be used to the English rule, so the referees are a bit more lax with the play of the ball. You saw the million-pound game between Toronto and the London Broncos. There's a lot of roll balls the referees didn't pick up, but here in Australia, the referees are onto it. Mediterranean Middle East. Radatovic, as he's done so often in this game, doing the hard stuff. Big man Nasser, Salman Nasser. So Rezzi playing your first receiver, Rafai playing like the 5'8 role. He's a very good run here from Jagadish. Jake Jagadish, he's certainly made an impact since he's come on. And he's left one of the players on his haunches in the background. Looks like it's Nathan Arnamott, the captain for ASEAN. In fact, it is the number 9. What about Jay Jagadish's run? Cleaned them up. It was Arnamott just receives a little bit of attention. Coming after this one, we've got the Latin Heat up against Africa United, followed by the PDRL test match between Australia and New Zealand. And then to finish off day six, we have Hong Kong up against Japan. That should be an absolute beauty. Both teams love throwing the ball around, as Mediterranean look to do the same. Ali Les has other ideas though. Just runs it up hard and fast. They come to the short side again with Tabaret. And breaking a half gap as Ahmed Kazem closed quickly though. So he'll just put the head down again, Ali Les. Pops it out the back. And as you can dive on it, it's a disappointing end to that set. Good run here from Jeff Peters. So, a couple of bodies there in the road. Could have tried to milk a penalty there, but decided to go the other way. Foley. Fredatovic had lined him up there. Just managed a little bit of a step. And played down there injured. Look at Fredatovic. Just notice there another new jersey out there. Looks like it's jersey 19, which would be the same here, Barney. Coming on for his first tackle, and he might have taken out his teammate doing so on the tackle. Seeing the replay. Can't really tell what's happened there. Just a bit of friendly fire, possibly. But, a bit of agony there, Fredatovic. I won't make a comment about what he's holding. He's up on his feet. Say is that he's very painful. Fredatovic. I think we've all been in that situation, and so we're all thinking of you, Luke Fredatovic. If you're joining into the stream, and let us know where you're watching from here. Bar TV bringing in the coverage. Paul Arundale in commentary. We're almost into the final 10 minutes of this one. 32-22, ASEAN over the Mediterranean Middle East. So coming into the right side, and it's been spilt. Mohammed Sultan will clean it up and give it to Ahmed Rezi. So Ahmed Rezi still wrestling. Eventually he will play it. Sultan comes in for another run. It's a good run from Mohammed Sultan. So here's Mir Barney. He's new onto the field. Same Mir Barney will play this 20 out from the line. So go through the hands of Rafayi. Gets around one. Can't get, oh, he flicks it out the back. Pretty good play there. Rezi with it, dancing around, palms off a few. He's brought to ground, 18 out from the line. Mitwari goes for a run from dummy half. He finds Prokopayo. Prokopayo still going. There's another player down in the background for ASEAN. So they've got 12 men in the defensive line at the moment. Mitwari, Tarabay, going back infield to Rafayi. Chance up quickly. Rafayi flicks it out the back. Tarabay dives on it, and the referee's going to call a knock on. A rush play there from Mediterranean Middle East. ASEAN were down to 12 men in the defence. They spilt the ball. So 32-22. the final 10 minutes of this one of the Confederate Cup. Third game in 5 days. We've got time off now. ASEAN players down. It could be one of the Kurnath boys. On Sunday, Africa United defeated ASEAN 28 points to 20. And the Mediterranean Middle East defeated Latin Heat 26-12. And on Tuesday, Mediterranean Middle East made it 2 from 2 when they defeated Africa United 35-18. And ASEAN picked up their first win 30-20 over the Latin Heat. So at the moment, Latin Heat again in front by 10. Just a little bit of cramp here. As I said, expected third game in 5 days. So we moved to St Mary's on Saturday for all the finals. Got 8 games, I believe, coming from St Mary's. 2 fields. Back underway. Tarabay finds Kazem. Kazem is having a good duel out there with Richard Mantate. Tarabay. Inside pass here to Mibani. 3 players to bring him down. He'll play these 4 short. Again, short pass here, it's a beauty. Armand Alaz, he's going to get there. Great pass from Hassan Rafaie, and Armand Alaz scores. Good try that keeps the Mediterranean Middle East in this one. You see the boys are running back quickly to get into position. See the replay, good short pass there from Rafaie. Armand Alaz still had a fair bit of work to do. Little left foot step, right foot step, and crosses for an important try. So Jay Jagadish, he looks like he's going to convert this one. He wasn't happy with the kicking tee. He's just swapped. He's going for the line green one.
ASEAN 32, Mediterranean Middle East 26 with a kick
to come. Jagadish, not a bad strike. The touch judges agree. It's now 32-28.
Score now, ASEAN 32, Mediterranean Middle East.
And margin back to 4. Just under 7 minutes remaining in this clash. ASEAN will take their time. So Tyler Champ will take his time.
Can Riley Lowe please come to the broadcast box?
So buckle up. We've got an exciting final 6 minutes of this clash of the Confederate Cup. Big contact there to restart from Pokapayu. And he's lost the ball. The referee says no, it's been pinched from Corey Kerner. So Mediterranean get a piggyback upfield. Armand Rezzi will find touch. So after ASEAN got out to a 14-point lead, it's back down to 4. Ali Alaz doesn't shy away from the busy stuff. He's a bit wary. Well, he spilled it from the dummy half. Code a bit wary. Saw a little bit of an opening. Just had a little bubble. Well, actually, it was Ali Alaz, so apologies to Hassan Rafai. Just saw a little bobble there from Ali Alaz. So ASEAN, a bit of gamesmanship here, just taking their time with the scrum. Just trying to eat up as much time as possible. It's one try in it. Richard Mante brought down centre field. Run from dummy half is Jeff Peters. He goes to the left hand side. Foley. Slow play the ball. There'll be plenty of this in the final minutes of play. Kerniff. So Arnold comes to the short side. Lateris. Arnold at dummy half again. James puts a kick into the end goals here, but it's well taken. Muhammad Sultan read that beautifully. Now Mediterranean Middle East miss out of their line, and ASEAN give away a penalty again inside the 10 metres. Crucial part of the game. They're going to find touch here. It's not going to find it. Eventually it does. It was a great effort from Richard Clark. Trying to catch that before it went into the touchline. Just got a hand to it as well, so it will be a scrum on the 40. So full set of six coming up for Mediterranean Middle East. Seconds tick down. Problem here with ASEAN, they don't want to eat up too much time, because if Mediterranean Middle East score, they'll need some time to hit back. So go through the hands here on the first play. Anwar tries to get around his opposite number. He does. Maybe comes around in defence. Tarabay. Alaz straightens things up. I'll take the tackle on the 10. There's a player who looks a bit injured there. They come the short side. Tarabay. Rezi. Flicks it out the back. Still alive here. Mithwari. Good tackle there from Mavie. The ball's come loose. Arnold picks it up. And Gill will hold the ball here. Kazim was trying to pinch it back off Gill. Final minutes of play here. Foley. He'll play this on the 10. He'll take his time. Kerniff. Doubling this one. Peters from dummy half. He runs hard. Could have been a higher tackle. I think Mitwari's also hurt himself in that tackle as well. He's come away a bit groggy. Peters has stayed down on the ground. From first view, it did look a bit high. We'll see it here on the replay. Definitely made contact higher, so Kota Mitwari could be in a little bit of trouble. As we say that, he's Kota Mitwari is receiving attention as well. Jeff Peters, see movement in the legs, which is good to see. So the trainer's just taking caution here. The referee's called time off, just to let the viewers know at home that the clock on your screen is just a guide. It's not the official time. So 4 points to the margin with a minute 28 left on the clock. So not the best way, but probably the players, if anything, would enjoy this little breather here. It's the third game in 5 days. Not that you want to see a player injured, but Team of trainers there for both teams with the water bottles going around to their troops. So if you're watching the coverage, just a little bit of a hold up here. Peters sits upright, which is good to see. Let us know where you're watching from. You're watching from the bathroom, so maybe don't share that information with us. If you're watching from the lounge room, on the bus, in a taxi, maybe you're watching from the pub. We are Bar TV Sports. Let us know where you're watching from. So Peters is up to his feet. He'll play this. 4 points in it. Can Asian hang on? Corey Kerner. Last tackle for Asian. Big kick coming up here. The wind's just got really strong. Maybe kicks into the wind. Enwar's underneath it. It's a good take close to the sideline. He runs centre field. Runs straight into Peters. So whatever's in that magic sponge, Jeff Peters is up and just puts a big hit on and forces the error. Big play from Jeff Peters. On the ground moments ago. So the final minute here. Asian with a scrum feet. Mediterranean Middle East have packed and the referee calls time off now. So they come this short side. Trent Kerner. The ASEAN bench is up on their feet, appealing for a penalty. Foley. I'll just go one out here, ASEAN. Just eat up time. Slow play the ball here. This should be the last play of the match. Corey Kerner. He's going to be driven back. But that's it. Full time, ASEAN have defeated the Mediterranean Middle East 32-28. They can celebrate. And boys, no need for that from Corey Kerner throwing the ball at the Mediterranean guys. Now things can erupt here. They just need to settle down. The game is over. And both players, a couple of forwards there, getting a bit heated, but the best thing they can do is cool off, go back to the shed, shake hands. So, bit of a fiery end to this one, but ASEAN have defeated the Mediterranean East 32-28. We'll take a quick break here and be back with the second game, the Latin Heat against Africa United.
next country I have here tonight with the Wolves, the Latin Heat versus Africa United.